18 years old, 6'4", 265. A guy that looked up at me and said, I've never seen a guy any bigger than you. You was in my house, boy. So, that's been my nickname for a long time. Yeah.
Certainly, Coach Gaines had, as I call, the whole package. He knew the game of basketball. He was able to teach the game of basketball. He was a great leader and cared about the people. And his teams played hard. I mean, they were afraid not to. But he's a bright man about basketball.
I love him dearly. There is no man on this planet Earth that I admire more than he. I look up to him, I respect him, I love him, he's a special man.
I've been very successful in my life, and I've been married now for 44 years, and a lot of that really for me started with observing and watching Mr. and Mrs. Gaines, both as a basketball coach, as a mentor, as a father figure, and as a teacher. For me, Coach Gaines was more than just a basketball coach. He was a father figure, he was a mentor, he was a teacher, and he was a believer in young men.
No matter how large I get or how high I climb or how much I grow, I'll always be the little guy that he coached at Winston-Salem. I'll always be the guy with the injured knee that he took into his program. Instead of shooting me like he shoot horses and like they shoot horses in Kentucky, I'm the same Steve. I'm not Stephen A. Then. I'm Steve. I'm Saul. Whatever other nickname he tried to come up with, but I'm always his guy. He's family. He was an individual that was a stickler for education, because at the end of the day, that's what you have to fall back on.
He was the one that stressed the importance about education. He was the one that stressed the importance about picking up the book. He was the one that said, if you can spend 2 hours on the basketball court, you can spend 2 hours reading a book.
It's not often that a colleague can judge his actions and his behavior by saying, I wonder what how Clarence would have done that, what Clarence would have said. He also made me a better person. I began to think of him more as a teacher, certainly a great coach, but a teacher, because that's the way he taught basketball to his players. But also a humanitarian. He did many great things in the community. And I think Winston-Salem was a much better place because Gaines was there. And our friendship has grown almost each decade, more and more in that vein other than just in basketball.
I'm proud of what the youngsters achieved, first of all, as individuals. Secondly, I'm also proud of the fact that they ended up as good ball players.
nicknamed Big House, became athletic director, concentrated on basketball to become America's greatest winning active coach when inducted into this Hall of Fame with 683 wins and 299 losses, and was the NCAA Coach of the Year in 1967 when his Rams won the NCAA title with a record of 30-2, and that the club was led by Earl the Pearl Monroe. John McLennan, will you please unveil Clarence Everett Ginn?
Winston Churchill.
It's been a kind of a service deal. I put something in, but I think I got more out.